Every day we are bombarded with thoughts. Some happy, some sad, some positive, and even some negative. This guided meditation will open your willing mind to latching on to the more positive and constructive thoughts and let go of the negative. In a moment, the music will change as you relax in your own way to experience a journey into your own mind that will bring self-realization, motivation, and positivity. You may relax any way that you feel comfortable, either with your eyes open or your eyes closed. To improve your experience, try to visualize this meditation in your mind as it progresses. It doesn't matter if you fall asleep during this time, as your subconscious will take over and absorb every word whilst you rest. There are 20 key thoughts or emotions covered in this meditation, starting with the negative to flush out unwanted thought processes, and the further along you get, you will feel lighter, contemplating life in a fresh and more positive way. With each thought or emotion, I would like you to feel what it means to you as if it were happening. It is not until we confront the negative blocks that we can then move on. If you are not ready or need to take a break throughout, pause this recording or come back to it at a later stage. The mind has to be willing to break through with an openness to see the new possibilities that you yourself offer. Okay, if you are ready, we shall begin. Remember, you can pause at any time and continue at your own pace. Anger, the emotion of pent-up frustration and tension. Without attaching anyone or anything to this thought, feel this emotion throughout your whole body. Be aware of its presence, from your toes to your neck, from your fingertips to your eyes. Anywhere you feel tension is where anger has manifested itself in the form of tense muscles. Now, being aware of the places where you feel this emotion, let go a little. Let your muscles relax and rest, like butter slowly melting, feeling smoother, looser, and more relaxed. Take in a deep breath now to release those muscles even more. Inhaling slowly, holding for a couple of seconds, and exhaling even slower. Let your mind rest knowing your body is more at ease now. Take a moment to relax further and deeper. Fear. The emotion of fear is manifested through unknown outcomes of situations yet to happen, if they happen at all. Relaxed and quite free, let fear sit with you gently from a distance. Quietly observe it, without attaching a person or a circumstance to it. Slow down the stirring feeling you have in your abdomen, feeling a warmth within those muscles of reassurance, self-worth, and confidence. Let the warmth rise from your abdomen to your heart area. The stronger this calming sensation gets, the more relaxed you are. Feeling warm, calm, and very relaxed. Be aware of your breathing. Without changing its pattern, notice it finding its own natural rhythm the more you observe. Inhaling and exhaling calmly. Sadness, the emotion of a negative outcome, resulting in feeling drained, quiet contemplation, and possibly withdrawing into yourself. Without attachment, experience this emotion, from feeling relaxed and perhaps numb, and think about how you would like to feel. Be aware of sadness in your mind and body, and embrace the change that you so seek. From feeling rock bottom to the way that you want to feel, change your own emotion right now. Like a light going from dim to shining bright. If you're having trouble, try visualizing your body filling with light as your emotion changes to the more positive one you search for. Imagine a bright white light encompassing your whole body, relax and bathe in this white light for a while. Disgust, the emotion of disapproval or repulsion. This emotion can bring you down, drain your energy, and literally play with your mind. Feel all the sensations. It may even bring about a little anger in your muscles. Be aware of changes to your breathing and tension in any part of your body. As soon as you notice any change, correct this by taking notice of each breath, listening closely as your body starts to relax again. If it helps, visualize the white light that you were filled with a moment ago. Let the feeling and sensations of this emotion fade out slowly, leaving you calm, relaxed, and breathing easily. Shame. The emotion of shame is very similar to disgust. The feeling of embarrassment, overwhelm, and shying away from people. Gain strength from this feeling as you imagine experiencing it throughout your whole body. You may feel as if your mind is trying to distance itself from your body in some way. Bring it back by recharging your body with more positive energy. As you exhale, visualize minus or negative symbols coming out from your mouth. As you inhale, visualize plus or positive signs being pulled in through your nose. As you fill up with positivity, the negative feelings and emotions will slowly be outnumbered. Envy, the emotion of resentfulness from someone else's situation, sometimes a bitter pill to swallow. This is one emotion that can be left behind, as it serves absolutely no purpose. The feeling of resent towards someone can only have a negative effect on you in the end, and is best at distance. Feel this emotion, sense the awareness from your body and mind that this feeling achieves, a negative thought pattern that can only go nowhere. The more this emotion sits, the more you will find yourself in a vicious cycle. Let go in your mind of all feelings of envy without care or attachment. It takes strength to let something go, and once you do, you instantly become stronger. Anticipation. This is more a feeling than an emotion, one of awaiting an outcome with expected results. Life can sometimes throw a curveball, and unexpected things happen. To hedge your bets on a particular outcome can come back to haunt us. Feel this emotion of anticipation with a sense of preparedness, ready for an either or outcome. Strength from inside is needed for this, and can be practiced through stillness and quietening the mind. Like a calm sea during a storm, you are still, relaxed, and strong. Trust. This feeling can be loose or very secure, like a padlock, and instincts play a big part as to how we feel towards someone or something. Feel trust in your mind and body. Trust comes from within, and more often than not, you are trusting a decision that you have made. Feel secure and positive before committing to this feeling, letting go of any negative vibes. Sense that you are making the right decision for you, and that the outcome will be in your favor. Let your mind take in strength, a secure feeling in knowing that you have all the right knowledge to let go and trust. Friendship. Friendship comes from within and can be extended to other people. A give and take, if you may. If all you are doing is one or the other, then this is not friendship. Balancing on an even level, give and take must be reciprocated on both sides. Feel the sense of balance throughout your mind and body, a good feeling if mastered correctly. There should be no tension or fluttering in the abdomen, as trust goes hand in hand with friendship. Being a friend to yourself should come first and foremost. Loving oneself from within is key to a great friendship. pride. This emotion can serve as an indicator of whether you are following the right path. To feel prideful about achievements or towards someone else is heartwarming, positive, and helps with motivation. To use pride to prove yourself to others and not back down when you're in the face of uncertainty can only bring a negativity inwards. Feel proud about something you have achieved in your life right now and help that motivate you from this moment on. Pride should be used only on oneself, like a humble piece inside. Patience. Patience is important in all areas of our life, especially having the time for ourselves. To grow and to understand the person inside you, patience serves the pace at which we grow. To ignore patience and what is going on inside ourselves is like walking into a dark room, not knowing what to expect. Patience in knowing that things take time to change or evolve will be seen in the end. Confusion, when everything seems to pull you one way and then another. You may be indecisive, shy away from things, or just not do anything. Take a moment to quieten your mind. See the confusion from a distance, as if watching it unfold on a theatre screen in front of you. From a distance, you will see the answers more clearly, and perhaps already know which decision you would like to make before this happens. Be aware of how you feel towards your decisions before you make them, and be comfortable before committing towards them. Courage. Before courage may come fear, think of that white light again, filling you up with positive energy. Having the courage to do something can only bring about good change. If you are being courageous about something, you are doing it on the premise that the outcome will be better than the present. To truly walk with courage, you need to feel it first. Feel your abdomen quieten down and become calm. Let that sensation work upwards to your sternum, working its way up as if courage has climbed onto your shoulders, protecting you. Be aware of this feeling right now. Respect. Respect comes in the form of give and take. If you are receiving something good, you will then reciprocate, giving something in equal value back. Respecting yourself comes first and foremost, from your own decisions and how you feel inside. Feel the respect for yourself flowing through your body. Fill your mind with a positive image of yourself. Appreciation. Appreciating even the small things can bring positive thinking, something as small as looking around your environment and seeing what you have, rather than what you don't. Appreciate yourself by taking time out, even if that be only a few minutes of the day. This can help boost your morale and encourage motivation within. Showing appreciation to someone else can even out the balance if you are slightly leaning towards a more negative emotion. Appreciation pays back in positivity, and the more this is practiced, the more inclined that good things will come to you. Gratitude. To have gratitude is to pay attention to your surroundings and yourself. Being thankful, much like appreciation, again pays back in equal or higher values. Feel gratitude around your heart area as a warmth that radiates a euphoric and balanced feeling. You may also fill yourself with white light at this time to strengthen what gratitude you may feel right now. Hope. To hope for something is to envisage a dream or a goal becoming real and manifesting itself in your life. Whatever you are hoping for, feel it within your heart and see it in your mind, as if you were there right now. Live your hope by working towards it, having patience and understanding that it may take time and a little hard work. To endeavor towards your hope, you are in the knowing that this is worth it in the end. Feel your face and shoulders relax as you realize your hope coming true. Love. The emotion to love and to be loved is one of selflessness, desire, and doing things in your best interest, even if those things seem hard. Benefiting from doing the right things can only bring a stronger love. Love is about action speaking louder than words. It is about being honest, loyal, and sticking with things through thick and thin. Whether that be the self-love you feel inside or towards someone else, basking in accomplishments throughout that relationship is true love. Happiness. From big achievements to the small things, happiness comes in all areas of our lives. To show gratitude can bring happiness. To show love can bring happiness. True happiness is felt as moments that can be recalled at any time. Think of a moment you were truly happy in your life and feel every positive aspect of it, as if you were there right now. Relax now, letting all negative feelings disperse and be replaced with more positive energy. Imagining the white light and warm feeling around your heart, you feel balanced, content, and strong. If you would like to fall asleep now, your subconscious will take in every word said in this meditation. If you have already fallen asleep, let your mind reinforce the ideas that you have heard by seeing positive mental images as you sleep. Take your focus now to your breathing. No need to change your rhythm, but just observe how you inhale and exhale. As you take notice of your breath, experience a slight loosening of your muscles without you having to do anything. Shift your focus to your shoulders. Ask yourself, can my shoulders be more relaxed? Just by being aware and taking notice, the automatic response to gently bring them down will occur. To help relax your shoulders more, practice this short exercise. Without moving, force your shoulders downwards. Slowly inhale as much as you can. Hold the air in for a couple of seconds, then smoothly exhale out of your mouth. Feel your shoulders relax and drop as you find relief in this moment. This exercise is short and can be done in any situation and will bring immediate results. Take notice of your breathing once more. Just be aware of a calmer and relaxed breathing pattern. No need to do anything, no need to rush. Just feel and experience slightly loosened muscles and easier breathing. Now, shift your focus to the top of your forehead, and as you scan downwards, your body will automatically start to relax. All you have to do is feel any present tension in those muscles. This works by just being aware, like quietly mentioning to your mind that it is okay to relax. As you progress through this, feel your body become heavier as you start to let go and just be present. Feel the area of your forehead with your mind, through your feelings and visualization. Once you have a good image, let your subconscious take over and help with the relaxation of those muscles. Feel the chain reaction as your forehead relaxes, like a wave of relief down to your eyes, smoothing them out and easing them comfortably. See with your mind again an image of your eyes. See their present state and replace that mental image with a more pleasant one of relaxation, calm, and stillness. Feel the effect of your willing to let go in your cheeks, nose, and lips. Letting go of all tension as you descend downwards. Your cheeks rest comfortable, your nose breathes easily, and your lips unpursed. See in your mind again this area of your body and replace the image with relaxation, relaxing more and more by seeing more stillness eases your mind. Your mind now having its own chain reaction as it sees and feels the validation in your body from just observing. Seeing your neck and shoulder muscles in your mind at their present state, take a mental picture and develop it like a photograph into one of calm, rest, and stillness. Feel the rested downward relaxation of your neck and shoulders as they untense and unravel automatically. Your breathing is now easier, your mind more calm, and everything seems so still. Take notice of your breathing once more, just being aware and observing. Let your body bathe in the more relaxed state of breathing with every gentle inhale and exhale. Your chest now more relaxed, taking a mental image of its present state. This time, let your muscles develop the photograph automatically. Easy, calm, and relaxed. Let that tranquil feeling slowly fold down to your abdomen, letting your stomach and back muscles relax. Take a moment to be present in what you have achieved. Possibly you are feeling a warm sensation around the center of your chest area. Possibly a euphoric feeling or sensation. Experience how much calmer your breathing is, like silk, smoothly inhaling and exhaling, filling with positivity and calmness with each breath. Feel the heavy effect of being relaxed from your already relaxed muscles. Be safe in the knowledge that you are only halfway there and that there is more relaxation to look forward to. Your mind is free, calm, and relaxed, as is your body, experiencing unparalleled stillness. Like that of a quiet forest. In here, in your mind, there is no wind, no noise, and no distractions. Quiet, calm, and still. Take notice now of your pelvis. Let the relaxation from your upper body melt down and encourage calm. Take a mental image of its present state and observe how your body reacts by untensing and letting go, developing the negative into the positive. Now relaxed, absorb this sensation like a cycle. What your mind sees, your body reacts. When your body reacts, your mind relaxes. As your mind relaxes, so too does your body, and the cycle goes back round. Shifting your focus now to your legs. Let them rest in a comfortable position, feeling heavy and unwinding as they do. Have no thought as they slowly descend down, but observe them in their present state. Let the mental image develop of its own accord, this time feeling the cycle of relaxation in its full glory, letting go more and more, relaxed, calm, and still. Let the wave of stillness smoothly approach your feet and toes, and as it does, appreciate the feeling of full relaxation. Your feet may slowly sit to the side, and your toes may splay out, as they too show gratitude from your conscious decision to relax more and more. Present state image you see in your mind is now felt from head to toe and in your mind. Quiet, calm, and very relaxed. feel the warm sensation around your chest and let it radiate to your whole body like an aura of soft white light. Gently bathing in the warm sensation of relaxation, calm and stillness, your body relaxes further and deeper the more you just let go. Your mind is quiet, no sound can be heard, and your eyes are truly eased with pure calmness. Bathe more in this tranquil state, and as you do, you relax more with each gentle breath that you take. How we perceive everything is through our eyes and ears, painting mental images of people and situations. These recordings are then etched into our mind. Sometimes the filter that sees perspective produces a twisted view of things. The more we think about certain thoughts, the more convoluted they become, to the point of being detrimental to our well-being and life in general. This can affect relationships, work, and our sense of forward thinking. If left too long, it can affect goals that you aspire to reach and dreams you wish to become reality, all slowly and subconsciously leading to a downward spiral and a vicious cycle. Achieving positive thinking takes time and patience with yourself. Like any change in life, it can be difficult, but is truly worth it in the end. Take a moment to vision the positive persona and personality that best fits you. See yourself in your mind's eye and imagine by visualizing how you feel when you let go of all that is holding you back. Once again, this mental image you see is ahead of you in time. Pretend to yourself that you are this person right now by seeing and filling up with positive energy. If it helps, place your future self in a positive situation that you would like to see yourself in. Let go of any resistance, feeling free to get lost in your own tranquility. Now it's time to go deeper, to ingrain that encouragement, to embrace positive change. You may gently slip into a trance-like state, or perhaps fall asleep in the next few minutes. No matter what happens, your subconscious will pick up every word and absorb true meaning to help you on your way. Relax deeper by inhaling once more and gently exhaling. As you exhale, feel your body wash with a wave of calm and stillness from head to toe. Experience the downward drift of relaxation by taking another slow breath. With each breath, your body becomes heavier, your mind quieter, and your breathing more steady. Imagine a sheet of silk above you, and as you inhale, the silk touches the top of your head. Soft, smooth, and light. As you gently exhale, the sheet of silk slowly brushes downwards to your toes, as if in time with your breathing. Breathe naturally now as the silk continues to lightly and softly soothe you. With each pass, you become more relaxed as the gentle fabric scans your body. Feel your muscles relax downwards in unison to the rhythm of your breathing and every pass of the silk, lightly touching your every emotion as your muscles descend downwards and your breathing deeper. Like a gentle breeze that caresses your body on a warm day, silk soothes you into calmness and relief. Your mind begins to be free as you enjoy this calm, relaxing mind massage. Whilst continued easy breaths ease you more and more, softly floating on a bed of relaxation, with every soft and deeper inhale and exhale. As you breathe deeper with each pass of the silk, your body sinks deeper, relaxing softly and automatically. Feeling like you're drifting on air, your body is light, relaxed, and generously calm. Nothing seems to matter at this time, as you drift more and more into these positive sensations you feel right now. Let your mind breathe in that pure relaxed state your body experiences by letting go completely. Nothing is important right now except how relaxed, calm, and still you feel. As you drift deeper and heavier, your mind comes to the conclusion that this positive feeling you have and how you have relaxed is from letting go of negative thoughts. If you were to hold on to any part of those old feelings, it would make it harder to achieve this state. And that's what they are right now. Old feelings. The old negative thoughts are now let go and buried deep in positivity throughout your mind and your whole body. As you are open to this new way of thinking, let your expectation of change be one of patience, and eventually, you will start to see positive changes around you, made from decisive and careful thought. you will begin to make your way forward in new ways that are relevant to you. Your first step is being honest with yourself, admitting that you, and only you, are holding yourself back. Once you are aware of this, every old thought process that surfaces will be noticed and corrected. Your ideas of how you will approach an obstacle in your life will change. People around you will have new meanings. Some of them perhaps you will get closer to, and some that maybe you will distance yourself from. You will take criticism only in the form of feedback, not taking anything personally, but using it to constructively improve on yourself. Learning from every step you take to positivity, you grow stronger and gain more confidence, the more you are aware of the change happening. Goals feel easier to achieve, and relationships start to bloom from the heart. All in all, your life and well-being will drastically improve. See yourself at the height of positivity, the relaxed you, your easy eyes, and your proud shoulders. You can do this. You believe in yourself. Feel what it means to be at the pinnacle of your utmost version of yourself. To begin your journey, imagine there is a staircase in front of you, with 10 steps downwards to a door. On the other side of the door is that version of yourself. In a moment, I will ask you to walk down the stairs and pass through the door, closing it behind you. Once you do, your journey will begin. I will count you down. Take your first step. Ten. Nine. Eight. Feeling relaxed and eager to begin the change needed. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Your mind and body calm and focused. Three. Two. Take in a deep breath as you reach the bottom step. And one. And open the door. We all have the ability to be motivated, to get things done. Just sometimes, those nagging thoughts of something being too hard, or it can't be done, come along. Listening to those subconscious thoughts can interfere with being motivated in starting and sticking with a routine. Your focus can also be compromised, and by allowing those thoughts to enter, can seem like a million voices telling you that you can't do something. Devices like your phone, computers, television, even friends and family can be distracting to the part of life that is yours. Somehow, what needs to be done is to separate those distracting things to allow you to function, perform, and realize your own potential in routine and focus. So, how do we do this? It all starts with seeing things for what they really are, and reprogramming your mind to pay less attention to those distractions. Picture now, in your mind's eye, your life by standing back a little to see what is really going on. Can you see yourself being distracted? What things are distracting you? in a calm manner, watch as the scenes unfold to reveal where your time is spent. With each realization, relax a little to signal to your mind that you understand and are aware. Do you become tired during the day from helping others too much, giving much more of your own needed energy to things that other people could do? Could other people help you more? All aspects of life are about give and take, and if all you are doing is giving, your energy will be spent. The same goes if someone is always taking. Life is transactional, much like a conversation. One person speaks, and then the other. Are there people around you that could use less of your help? Are you made to feel guilty, or do you just feel guilty for not helping? Being that helpful person, you're allowing someone to actively participate as a distraction in your own life. Possibly they ask you for help with their tasks or relationship problems, whilst giving nothing back. This can be draining towards energy that could be otherwise spent on yourself. Look upon this scene to see how you could change the situation. Know that it's okay to voice your thoughts to someone, and almost always, respect will be given, possibly opening a fresh relationship with that person. Are you holding yourself back by putting things off, whilst in actuality, today's tomorrow becomes another yesterday? Remember, on the other side of fear and hard work is something worthwhile. ask yourself these questions. There is no need to have an answer right now, as this may come later, even after this meditation. Quietly ask, am I helping others too much? Are there tasks that could be given to someone else? Can my time be utilized more efficiently? Relax now, and just let these questions pass through without attachment, as if seeing them float past and fade off into the distance. The answers will come in their own time. Your focus comes from setting routine. Once distractions are out the way, only then you can focus. Okay, again, in your mind's eye, visualize that you have cleaned out all things that take you away from what you would like to achieve. With clear time and space, you can now get on and do things. Imagine now that you are achieving what you would like to do with absolutely no resistance at all. The further and deeper you imagine this mental image, the more focused you are, the more you get done. You can now see how momentum builds from routine to focus and now to being motivated. Motivation comes not from starting something, it comes from the doing. Clear a space in your mind, an area that is going to be the foundation and building block for you to begin change. Imagine a room in your mind, empty and quiet. the only things in this room are the ones needed to complete your own tasks. There is no one here that doesn't need to be here, and you have all you need right here, right now. Start from scratch, a project that you would like to complete that is personal to you. In the beginning, it may take some planning and figuring out how things will go, but as you progress, you become faster and more efficient as your confidence grows. See colors start to bloom in the joy of doing, and notice how this makes you feel. That fuzzy energy feeling around your whole body is telling you that you are on the right track, filled with adrenaline, pumping fresh energy into more and more motivation. Your mind starts to branch into new ideas, feeling more alive and even more motivated. You are now competent at what you do. The strength you have shown yourself feeds you more and more. Being aware of learning focus, you are now aware that focus gets things done. Courage and confidence from starting will grow more and more. By doing all this, you are also keeping negativity away. From focus comes results. From this moment on, you will no longer overthink a situation before it happens. You will consciously dive in and absorb yourself into it. Without thinking too much, you will find yourself gaining fantastic results just from doing. As long as you are honest with yourself and others, your routine and focus need not be neglected. Being ready is the all-important first baby step needed, and the second, placing the other foot forward. One one small step can create momentum. And we all know nothing comes from standing still. You are your own force, and your mind is under your control. It is all a matter of being aware and noticing the small things sneaking up on you. Ask yourself, do I need to do this right now? Is it really important? When people ask you for help all the time, do they really need my help? Is my advice falling on ears that do not listen? How can I clear a way to start my routine? What ways can I improve my focus? The more you listen to this guided meditation, the more these ideas will embed themselves in your subconscious. Overall, you will catch yourself asking these questions when a situation arises. Have the courage to put distractions off for the better good until you are ready. Things that are important to you will eventually take precedence, and through practice, this can be achieved. Now, in your mind's eye, picture a scene of mist or fog in a dark background. All you see is the smoky-looking atmosphere. Through the fog, you can see silhouettes of people, but you can't quite make out who these people are, but they will make themselves known in the next few minutes. Now imagine a light shining dimly from behind this smoggy scene, lighting the individuals more into shapes but still with no features that are familiar to you. In a moment, you will begin to discern which people are good for your own individual needs, and that offer a two-way street of reciprocation. Also, seeing any negative or toxic relationships that perhaps can stay in that foggy and unclear place. Let your mind be free of thought and judgment. Let yourself think of someone you know who has been good for you, inspiring encouragement, understanding, and true friendship. This can be a friend, a family member, or someone you know outside these circles. As this individual steps forward out of the haze, what feelings and emotions do you feel as you see them more clearly? let your mind discern and translate what you are feeling right now. Does this person always give you the time of day? Is your time and their energy reciprocated, resulting in an even balance? Do you have respect for this person? And furthermore, do they have respect for you? Does this individual encourage you or hold you back? Just ask yourself these questions to clarify your relationship between you and them. Occasionally, you may have to give more of yourself than to receive. But if this person is true to you, in your mind, you will know if they are right or wrong for you. Perhaps they have had things going on in their own life, taking up valuable energy to be able to give it to you. Perhaps even you are in this position and feel as if you could be there more for them. No matter which way around, if this is the case, just let this sit with you for a moment. You will come back to this first person later on. I would like you to think about someone perhaps who can be a negative influence on you. Without forming a face in your mind, look into the fog, seeing silhouettes of individuals again. Think of what it means to you to be let down, disappointed, and maybe giving up too much of your own time and energy to someone that does not equally respond to your kindness to them. As you sit with this emotion, another figure moves forward out of the fog. As they emerge, you see their face. You are safe, and your energy will not be depleted at this time, as you are in control. How does this person make you feel when you see their face? Do you feel they do not make as much effort to you as you think they should? What makes them a bad influence? Is there anything going on in this person's life that could make them act the way they do around you at the moment? Like attracts like in life, and if this person has different views on things, and perhaps things going on that you cannot help them with, your friendship could only go as far as a one-way street. You and this individual may have disagreements, possibly never reaching understanding to the point of breakdown of communication. If this is the case, how often does this happen? Can it be avoided? Are you willing to push forward to maintain and improve on this relationship? Or is it too toxic for you to carry on? If they have changed due to a situation around them, will their situation change? And are you willing to allow time to heal this relationship? Let these questions sit on your mind for now. No need to answer them at the moment. the answers will come to you, perhaps later on. In front of you are two completely different levels of emotion in the forms of two people you know. Having made clear distinctions between the two, how can you balance out and create a level playing field for yourself? Your well-being is of the utmost importance as you stand between these two very different individuals. Now, let your mind wander as you think about friends, family, and acquaintances you meet. In the fog, these people will emerge very soon. The two people you have separated as being very different, one a positive influence and the other a negative, now stand on separate sides. As you calmly see through the fog, they start to emerge, clearly seeing their faces. As they emerge, your mind automatically places each person on the side of either the positive or negative person, separating them into two groups. Calmly watch their faces as they appear and automatically take a side. Now, everyone is in place and is on one side or the other. Take notice of whom is a positive influencer in your life, the people that inspire you, encourage and reciprocate, the people who stand by your side and take time to notice you. Now take a look at the other group of people, the negative influencers, the people who take your time and possibly never give anything back, people who perhaps judge you without reason and possibly have jealousy towards you. Now, in your mind's eye, stand between the groups, taking a good look at who is in each group. Ask yourself, is this proportion right? Are the right people in the right group? Let this sit with you for a moment. Possibly, some of the people may have switched sides, and it is now up to you to decide who you now give your precious time and energy to. Have these next few moments to let your mind relax enough for you to see things clearly and calmly, to better inform your conscious on where you spend your time and energy. Please remember that some traits and feelings may have come through strongly right now. Only the best decisions are made from contemplation and clear thinking. Confidence comes from the people and things that surround you. What you see and hear is what you are used to. Kinda goes with the saying, what you see is what you get. To step outside this comfort zone may feel alien, detached, and possibly uneasy. It may feel safer to stay inside the realms of known versus making changes in the unknown. But the real possibility of dreams that can be realized and the spiritual growth that you will experience will help you better understand yourself. Growth, wisdom, and learning comes only from new experiences, and to experience new things, you have to at some point step outside your comfort zone. Comfort zones come with rewards. They can be material, they can be spiritual. Imagine this scene in your mind. Think of a toddler comfortable in the arms of a parent. It is safe, it is familiar, and you know the outcome already because nothing will change in this atmosphere. Now, introduce a family member on the other side of the room who is calling the toddler and also has some kind of treat or reward. The toddler sees this and his or her eyes light up with excitement at the prospect of receiving the treat. The only problem is, the toddler has to do a little work to get rewarded. Having to walk over to a seemingly unfamiliar person and away from the clutches of safety could feel daunting. There may be hesitation to begin with, but if the desire to make it to the other side to receive that reward is strong, then motivation will override the hesitant thoughts. As the toddler places the first foot forward, slight anxiety may occur, as stepping away from familiar safety can be uncertain. With the second foot stepping forward, the anxious feelings dissipate slightly. As the journey is underway, there is commitment. Placing one foot in front of the other becomes easier the further along the toddler gets. Once there and holding the reward, there is pride in making it, and also grasping the idea that making changes is sometimes good. The toddler learned an invaluable lesson that on the other side of fear is something safe and beneficial. The starting point for change came from the idea of a goal or reward. From seeing this, even in the mind's eye, and thinking about it, came motivation. From motivation came the first steps, which may be uneasy and unfamiliar, to confidence in nearing the end of that particular journey. And at the end, on receiving that prize, came pride, joy, and a lesson learned. The moral of this story is, with even minor changes, difficult obstacles and improvements in your life can be made. Through trusting yourself and having to go against the now present tide, comes confidence to change yet more, to live the life you may desire. Sit for a while now to picture in your mind's eye a dream or goal that you would like to achieve. It may be in the form of a personal accolade, improving a relationship, or it may be something material that you desire to have. Picture it as if you were already there. Now, think about anything your mind is telling you why you can't do this. You will find that there is no real answer except distraction and possibly seeking approval from others. See in your mind what needs to be done, or perhaps changed, to get to where you want to be, to receive your desire. Any seemingly negative thoughts can be left just to float on by, without attachment, like clouds in the sky. Imagine your desired outcome now, as if you only had to walk across the room to get it. See it clearly, feel the emotion as if you already have it. Visualize placing one foot in front of the other, as you take your first step, leaving fear behind and only looking forward. Focusing on this one and only thing that matters to you. Take another step, the second feeling more free and willing than the first. Once both feet have taken their first steps to their destination, each step after will become easier and guilt-free. Take another step, this time feeling slightly lighter as you move forward with your plans. Breathing in the pride as you take your fourth step, you feel momentum build in speed to reach your desired goal. Take one more, and another, and one more. Having reached your reward for stepping outside your comfort zone, you feel your face relax as you absorb yourself in achievement. take a quick look back, you now see that those first steps may have been hard to initiate, but the journey as a whole was one of ease as you progressed. You have it inside you to make anything happen by visualizing your reward, committing, and taking those first steps. Sit now for a while to see yourself having reached your goals. Also, see the positive changes inside you as you achieve finishing your journey. As you find the answers to make your own way ahead, have patience in knowing the answers may not come straight away, but after you have finished this meditation. Relax now. Imagine a blackboard in front of you. You can see the slate board, empty, blank. Beneath is a stick of chalk with a cloth by its side. There is nothing else in front or behind you. In your mind, step forward and take the chalk in your hand. You rub the chalk around in your hand, feeling its smooth texture, and see the white dust powder as it passes through your hand. It feels quite therapeutic, leaving your fingers feeling smooth. Anything on your mind can be placed or transferred onto the board just by writing with the chalk. Take a sleepy second as you gather your thoughts, ready to etch them onto the slate in front of you. When you are ready, write a feeling or thought that is playing on your mind. Whilst doing this, feel the chalk in your hand, the sound it makes, and see the powdery dust float to the floor. After writing your thought or feeling and seeing it clearly in your mind, take the cloth and wipe the board clean, leaving no trace of any chalk. Writing your thoughts onto the board is a form of transference. You are consciously and subconsciously letting go, even if just for now. With each thought you let go, the more relaxed you feel, and the more accepting you are for sleep. Wiping the thought off the board is a secondary release, kind of like saying goodbye to the emotion placed in your writing. By wiping every trace of letter and chalk, you are releasing tense feelings, worry you may have had, and inviting sleep into your calmer mind. The more you write onto the board and wipe off, the darker the blackboard becomes. Wiping away to a clear mind and a calm body. The more you place onto the board, the smaller the chalk becomes, and the more faint your writing is. By now, you may feel your shoulders have relaxed as you let go of unwanted feelings. Your shoulders feel as smooth as the chalk. The more you think about this sensation, the more you relax. The darkness you see behind your eyelids are a positive sign that sleep is imminent. Visualizing the blackboard getting darker, your eyes only see a calm blank canvas in front of them. With each wipe of the board, you are wiping away to a clear mind. Closing down any chatter to perhaps a dull hum. Peace of mind comes from any slight relief you may feel from this quieter environment. The hum you hear intertwines with the music you can hear. The more you listen, the more soothing it becomes. From bathing your mind in the more silent atmosphere, your head and neck relax into a comfortable position, relaxing gently, feeling as though they are now floating on air. The blackboard in front of you slowly starts to become more dull in your mind, as sleep begins to take over. The outline of the board becomes darker, and the words you have written seem slightly out of focus. As you continue to write, your hand becomes tired from shaping words on the blackboard. The more time you spend writing, the heavier your hand feels, and the board becomes harder to focus with your eyes. Your eyes start to flutter, closing slightly as you try to focus more on the board. Your fingers hold onto the chalk as your hand and arm slowly make their way downwards. Your shoulders feeling the ever more sensation of letting go. And now your chest relaxes, helping you to breathe more easily into a more rhythmic pattern. Finding it easier to keep your eyelids closed, they relent and stay down. All you see now is the quieter interior of your mind. All sound seems to have dispersed too. The hum you heard a moment ago seems even more distant. Your back relaxes from the intensely blissful feeling your shoulders have sent down. This wave of calm is felt through your whole body. Letting go of all and everything, you begin to feel light as your arms dangle to the sides of you, feeling as though you are starting to float. With your arms by your sides, you are deeply relaxed. A sensation of lifting off the ground can be felt with your arms, hands and wrists now feeling very limp. Your legs slowly sway with the movement of your body as you feel yourself float upwards. Ascending slowly higher, your body becomes relaxed and very loose. Only gravity can be felt as your arms and legs gently sway. Your head rests in a comfortable position and your body breathes easily. As you float higher, with your subconscious mind, you look downwards towards where the blackboard was. Your mind feels at peace, knowing that there is distance between your writings you left on the board below. Wiped clean and now distancing yourself from those emotions are comforting and satisfying. your mind is content with having a break by having some much needed quiet time. This purely relaxing feeling creates healing within your conscious and subconscious. Time away from overly thinking can begin feeding your mind calm, a clearness, and peace. You become more and more relaxed as you float further away from the blackboard. Your worries are now a dot in the distance below. Take some time to bathe in this quiet bliss. Now, not being able to see anything of the blackboard below, you begin to float slowly in a new direction. Floating in and through clouds brings even more peace to you. Each cloud you float through helps to close your eyes even more. As you fly through one fluffy cloud and through another, your eyes automatically respond by closing. With each cloud passed, your eyes become heavier and heavier. Your body feels deeply relaxed the more you let go. As you fly silently, in the distance you see the softest bed floating within a cloud. The closer you get, you can see the deepest mattress you have ever seen. Pillows that are plush, thick and soft, and the material covering this oasis is of the highest quality. You float gently above this bed, looking down. Your arms limp and loose, and your legs only feeling gravity. You are gently pulled downwards to this beckoning escape. As your feet touch the soft material, your toes relax. Your ankles feel the calm sensation too. Your legs instantly become weak from resting on this bed. Your thighs and hips invite your back to feel this blissful feeling too. As your chest and upper back touch the material, your breathing becomes easier. Your neck and head rest gently on the softest pillow, feeling at home and very relaxed. Your whole body sighs with relief at the healing sensation this bed brings. Never feeling anything like this before, you relax and now feel safe. Away from interruption, floating in a sleep odyssey that is yours. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.